So per schedule at 9 this morning, Dr. Cardile at Unity Healthcare saw me to review the test results, the blood test results, and they came back positive for internal bleeding somewhere in the gastrointestinal tract. She asked me to get a series of tests done, an exam that is done through the throat down into the stomach, and then a rectal exam, I guess it is. In any case, they insert a tube up through which is two different hospital visits, same hospital, but two different visits, or maybe three. She's bewitching in the sense, Dr. Cardile is, that she is just so intensely kind. A Georgetown grad, I've had the most premium care, healthcare, since I was born. I crave good service, so I'm not easily pleased, and this Unity Healthcare is just extraordinary. I'm homeless. I have no money. I do have Medicaid. But it is explicitly clear they don't care if you have money. They don't care if you have Medicaid. I told today Dr. Cardile how stunned I am with how people are treated. And she said, we believe that healthcare is a right. Everyone here does. She's a Georgetown grad, clearly could be in some wealthy suburb in plastic surgery or some specialty making a fortune. Everyone there, from the receptionist to the, I'll guess, medical technicians that take vital signs and such, professional, respectful. There's a placard from Unity Healthcare right by the reception window that appropriately says, clients, if you, or patients, if you're feeling you're not receiving respectful, kind, courteous, professional care, please let the manager know, and his name was listed. But it's obvious that the care and the respect that employees there deliver is not because they have to, it's because they want to. So she asked me to get this series of tests, and she's so bewitching, her kindness. I never thought to say anything. Actually, I did think to say something. I said, are these tests, are they going to cost the healthcare system a lot of money? And she said no, and I took her at her word. So I said, sure. So we finished our consultation, and she took me elsewhere on the premises to where the scheduling nurse, I guess you would call her, would make appointments for the test to be performed. As I was sitting there, I thought, you're not going to be alive 2 months from now. Why are you getting these tests? I had also, some time ago, scheduled a dental exam because my teeth are shattering from my nocturnal grinding. Really shattering now. I've seen it coming for decades. So I politely told the scheduling nurse, I'm sorry, I know this sounds really strange. Dr. Cardile will understand what I'm saying, whether or not she agrees. I'm not going to be alive 2 months from now. It doesn't make any sense to schedule these tests. Thank you very much. At which point I walked out and told the other scheduling nurse, please cancel my dental appointment, and asked her to update Dr. Cardile on my decision. She certainly deserves that respect. I don't have the background to have guessed internal bleeding of my symptoms for the last 6 months, but it sure makes sense. It seems to be triggered by when I eat anything, and I'm eating 800 calories a day. Incidentally, my weight is pretty well on appropriate track on these things. I lose about half a pound a day, and I was down 4 pounds from a week ago, so I'm now at 160. Five pounds over my zero fat weight. But when I eat, that seems to be what triggers the bleeding, and afterwards I feel anemic. I feel tired. I feel depleted. It hurts. It aches. It's comforting to know what's going on after all these months. Other than that, my vitals are fine. I'm not retaining, my blood oxygen level isn't what it should be by a little bit, presumably because of the anemia. But blood pressure was fine, heart rate was fine. She prescribed, asked me to take iron pills, and I said I would. I'd pick up that prescription this afternoon, two or three a day. I'm kind of hurting now because I just had my 400 calories for the day, and whatever goes on in my stomach, bleeding or otherwise, seems to be happening. But that'll subside in a while, and then I'll be back at fighting force. So that's the update.